Hey, I'm Amanda Howell, your host for PopFlixs, and this week we're going to be reviewing the movie Source Code, starring Jake Gyllenhaal, Michelle Moynihan, Vera Farmiga, directed by Duncan Jones, and written by Ben Ripley. So the movie opens up, and Jake Gyllenhaal, who plays Captain Colter Stevens, is on a train, sleeping, and he is jolted awake. And you can't really figure out why he seems so out of sorts, and then you soon realize, as does he, that he is a part of a government agency, or a government program, if you will, where he can jump into somebody else's life for the last 8 minutes of their life. And the whole reason that he's doing this is because there was a commuter train on its way into Chicago in the morning that was blown up by a bomb. And so he is being sent by the government to try to stop any future attacks on downtown Chicago that they think could lead out of this first attack that happened, if you will. And so he has to continually relive these last 8 minutes of this guy's life. Don't ask me why it's 8 minutes. I guess 9 minutes is a little too long. Maybe he'd figure it out too fast. We'd have no movie. Who knows? But so he keeps reliving these 8 minutes of his life, or this guy's life. And along the way, he is figuring out different relationships with Michelle, who becomes his love interest, and also with Vera Farmiga, who he starts to learn to appreciate in a different way. So why don't we take a look at the trailer, and we'll be right back.
Sean! I took your advice. It was very good advice. Sean.
Look, I can see that you think you know me, but I don't know who you are. My name is Captain Colter Stevens.
You're kind of freaking me out.
No.
Talk to me, Sean.
Look, I don't know who Sean is, and I don't know who you are.
Welcome back, Captain Stevens.
Where am I?
You are inside the source code.
What is the source code?
It's a computer program, Captain.
Source code enables you to cross over into another man's identity in the last 8 minutes of his life.
1:48 this morning, a bomb exploded on a train outside of Chicago, killing everyone on board. A man named Sean Fentress was on that train. He is now you. Think, Captain, remember back. Who bombed the train?
I don't know who bombed the train!
Then try again.
Wait, no, I...
So, what do you think?
It's the same train, but it's different.
If you find the bomber, the next attack can be prevented. Concentrate on the passengers in your car. Look for ones who seem nervous. As always, you will have 8 minutes.
8 minutes, and then I blow up again. What would you do if you knew you had less than 8 minutes to live?
I'd make those seconds count.
I want to go back in. I'm going to save her.
You can't. It doesn't work that way.
Christina is dead.
She doesn't have to be.
You cannot alter this reality while inside the source code.
I'm asking you to have the decency to let me try.
Tell me everything's going to be okay.
Everything's going to be okay.
Okay, so in my opinion, at least from first glance, what I thought was, well, this is just a new science fiction version of Groundhog Day. A movie which I love, but I don't know, I felt like the plot didn't always seem to hold my attention, and I felt like some of the things that they were trying to throw out there seemed a little far-fetched. And the thing that saved the movie the entire time was the acting. Jake Gyllenhaal did an amazing job. He is always really, really great at cutting through with those dramatic, intense, lovey-dovey moments, but then he also balances the subtle humor from things continually repeating within those 8 minutes. And Vera Farmiga also really does an amazing job of transforming where her character starts and then where her character gets to by the end of the film. So overall, I would say that I give this maybe 3 out of 5 popcorn bags. So check it out and let me know what you think. And we'll be back next week on PopFlixs reviewing the movie Arthur. Thanks so much for joining. See you soon.
Topic!